Hello everyone. Today I want to talk about another indicator called linear regression intercept indicator. Let me add this to the chart. We are looking at pound US dollar at the moment, and we are on 1 hour chart. This indicator we can use on any time frame, but I think on smaller time frames it works better. If you're using sorry 8 hour pro charts, you should go to the settings, start is one, and then look for linear regression intercept here. We leave the period as 14 and the intercept color I'm gonna make it blue. Create. Okay, you can see this line here. Linear regression intercept indicator is one type of indicator which is calculated by using the linear regression technique, the same as linear regression forecast indicator which we covered on the previous video. Some people just use this indicator by itself, so anytime that price goes below the indicator, if they are in the downtrend, then you know we can place a sell order. But to make it more clear, I combine this one with linear regression forecast indicator. As you can see, we can add the forecast one here. I leave it as 14, so they have the same periods. The color, I'm changing the color to something else like green maybe, then create. You can see that linear reg forecast indicator, and this one is a linear reg intercept indicator. If you add these two indicators in one chart, then they act exactly like MA, you know, moving averages. And the speed, it depends on the period, what period you choose. So you add them to the chart, then you follow the strategy the same as two moving averages. As you can see, during the bearish price movement here, LRI or linear regression intercept goes above LRF, and in a bullish price movement, LRI goes above LRF. You can see here. Okay, so we are in bullish here, and LRF is above. Then here we are in bearish. Most of the time, LRF is below. Okay. the LRI indicator, as I said, is part of the linear regression series, and all of LR indicators have some unique features in, you know, predicting the future prices. As you can see, we discussed about the change of direction can help us to determine change of trend. Here we had a very good change of direction in both indicators, but the forecast one gives us the forecast, so it shows us and it gives us an early indication of the trend direction change. If you want to test this indicator, you can see here we had the first sell, then exit here, again first sell, second sell, and exit here. So always when you are in downtrend, only listen to the sell signals, and if you are in uptrend, listen to the buy signals and add to the position as you go. I think we covered everything for this indicator. We normally don't discuss the formula and how this thing calculates, but if you want to ask, I'm happy to help you in calculations if you want to just, you know, develop a program or something and you are looking for the formula, I can help you to find those ones as well. I hope you enjoyed this and you learned something today. Have a nice day. See you later.